instructions classroom. We had a new blue sheet. Instead of doing little boxes, I did little smiley faces. I think I had a little too much time on my hand. I went and came in on that Friday that you guys had off, and I got a lot of work done. So I planned us all the way till February 2nd. It's a long time till our first test, and we got a couple quizzes in there. Somebody tell me, when's the first quiz? Tuesday. What will I do on Tuesday? I will collect all of your homework. How many homeworks will there be? Five. Perfect. You guys are all in the thing. And even a lot of little reminders there, too, so you can use these smiley faces as checkoffs. You want to rip out these pages tonight. We'll use one of them tomorrow. So if you can go back home to your books and rip them out. We will have a second edition of our book coming out soon. So you're going to go ahead and just rip these out when you get home tonight and finish up the worksheet that is green. You should have grabbed when you walked in. Today what we're going to do is we're going to use operations of functions. We're going to add, subtract, multiply, and divide. You're going to be like, Ms. Shackton, we've done this before. We've done a lot of this before. You just got to kind of bring it from the back of your brain to the front. There's already a key for the homework up on Focus, and there's one in the classroom that I'll provide afterwards. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and add these together. So what they do is they're going to give you two functions. So they're going to go ahead, and I'll color code a little bit. We'll use some blue and red. We're going to go ahead and take the F function, which is this one. So I'm just focusing on the function part. The f of x just labels it, so it tells me where to go. And so that would be the function that I'm going to use. And what am I going to do with it? I'm going to add it to the g function. So I'm just going to add these together. So not too bad as a starting problem. So I take the f of x, I just write it down. And then what am I going to do? I'm going to go ahead and add it, because that's what the operation is in the middle, to the g function. I was well the whole break, and then Mr. Shackton was a little sick. And just yesterday, I was like, my throat is scratchy. Oh my gosh. Did you get me sick right as we're going back? What do we actually do when we add these functions together? What do we call that? Combining like terms. Mm-hmm. So we're going to just go ahead and combine like terms. So what could I add with the x to the second, the negative x to the second? The 2x to the second, good. And Evan, when I add those, what do I end up with? Negative x to the second plus 2x to the second? Just an x to the second, 1x to the second. So Evan knows that we're going to add the negative 1 and the positive 2, just giving us an x to the second. What's the next things I can add together? What do you think, Luke? What else could be added together? Yeah, I'll just put that 3x down there. He doesn't have any friends, right? We're all done with him. And then, how about, Grace, what would I add together next? I know. This is not too bad, huh, for a first lesson back. So 1 and the negative 5, and what does that add to? Negative 4. You are done. That is your function. Those are those two functions added together, and that's your answer. The only other part of that is they're going to now say, what's the domain? What does domain actually talk about? X's. So what the question is what can my x's be? So sometimes I write that in there. Like when they're asking me the domain, they're just asking me what can I put in for x's. So what types of numbers could I put in for these x's? Could I put positive numbers there? Could I put a negative number there? Like plug in a negative 2? Sure. Could I put a decimal in there? Yeah. So how do we represent that I can put anything there? All real numbers. Okay. And it's going to be all real numbers for your domain for almost everything. There's exceptions. The only exceptions fall is when we have to be really careful is when we see fractions. We know we don't like that F word fraction. And when we see radicals. So if you see a radical or you see a fraction come up, it'll be the fractions in this section. You know that you've got to stop. Your domain is not going to be all real numbers. There's going to be some restrictions. So those are the two things that cause restrictions. Okay. And what they do is a lot of times they give you two functions. They have you add them. They have you subtract them. They have you multiply them and divide them. Do everything you possibly can with those functions. And that is pretty much all we're doing today. When we divide them, however, the factoring will come together. Did you guys notice? I put my new tattoo. Isn't it so pretty? It's my grandmother's signature, so we did a tattoo party over the break. Oh, I'm video. I probably shouldn't put that in the video. It's my grandmother's signature, though. That's a sweet one, right? Yeah. I've been wanting a wrist tattoo forever. So over the break, I ended up getting, we had a tattoo party at my grandmother's house. She turned 88. And my sister got the same one. My cousin got the same one on her side. And then we did different kind of spins off of it. So eight of us all. Mr. Shackton has it too. So when you see Mr. Shackton later, you'll have to see his new one. So he did the little clover too, in like honor of my grandmother. My grandmother's still alive, so not in memory. So but she's 88. Oh my gosh. Can you imagine being 88? Oh my gosh, it's crazy. It's like half my age. Oh my gosh, I'm halfway to 88. That's crazy. Okay, anyways, let's go back over here. But yeah, I just keep noticing it as I'm like teaching. I'm like, oh yeah, I got a new tattoo. This is so cute. Now we're going to do subtraction. When we do subtraction, I would tell you guys that you need to remember to use some parentheses. So you want to use parentheses. And does anybody remember why? Why does it make a difference to use parentheses? Anybody remember? What do we do with subtraction ones? We change the signs. We're going to remember to distribute to the second one. And the other thing is the order really matters. So just like we read left to right, we're going to set these up left to right. So if it says the F function, that's the one you have to start with, and that's going to be important tomorrow. So the order does matter with subtraction and division. So just always go in the order of the problem. So you're going to write the first one. I put them both in parentheses just because I'm using subtraction now. And so now I'm going to subtract, and then I'm going to subtract the whole G function. Do you guys see where I'm getting that from? Any questions about the setup? And now that that's set up, I'm going to go ahead and distribute. So when I distribute, I only distribute to the second parentheses. Make sure all those phones are away. The first one does not change, and that's why the order is going to be really important. They're going to have you kind of subtract them in both order, in both orders too, sometimes so you see the difference. So we see this. What is the blue going to change to? About Coraline, what would you go ahead and get when we go ahead and distribute that? Negative 2x squared plus 5. Awesome. Thank you. And so after you go ahead and distribute that, now you're going to do what? Add like terms. Good. Sid, what should I add together? Good. What does it give me? Yeah, negative 3x squared. Beautiful. What should go next to the negative 3x squared? Lenny, you want to help me with that? What should go next to it? Just the plus 3. Good. And so he doesn't have any friends. He's all by himself. And Ulysses, what goes next to the plus 3? 6. Where'd you get the 6 from? 1 and 5 added together. You guys are my superstar class. That's why I picked you for my evaluation. A lot of the kids in here are super strong. So is there any questions about how we got to there? Okay. Now we're going to talk about the domain. Levi, what do you think the domain is? All real numbers, yeah. Why is it all real numbers? Because I can pick anything I want for x. What domain means is just what can the x values be. I can plug in a 2, I can plug in a negative 3. We'll do that later on. I'm not going to do that today. We'll do that tomorrow. But we'll go ahead and see that our domain is all real numbers. I can pick any number I want. What's the only thing that's going to cause an exception to the domain? Fractions and radicals. And there aren't many radicals in this section, but it's just nice to know that radicals have exceptions. Why would a radical cause an exception? What can we not put underneath a radical? A negative, yeah. So those complex numbers cause that. Very good. Okay, we are halfway through our lesson, so now we'll do a multiplying and dividing. Is my pace okay? When you guys are going forward, I'll give anyone that didn't copy it a second to copy it, and now I'll get all the extra credit. So I'll go around and just give anybody extra credit that copied the notes. Did you get a copy? Oh, you just got them now? Okay. Anybody else can copy the notes? No? It's extra credit, so don't get upset if you no hand copy? No. Oh. No. Did you hand copy or no? Okay, that's okay. there's no upset. It's a new year, whatever. No, you're just a fast writer. Okay, cool. Okay, cool. Anybody else can copy the order? The notes still? Can copy? Okay. Now what we're going to do, and that should have given everybody probably enough time to go ahead and write down these this problem, is we'll go ahead and, paperwork. We'll go ahead and now we're going to multiply. So when we multiply, I would also suggest that you use parentheses, okay? So when we're multiplying, we do what's called distributing. So again, I'll color code. We'll take the F function, which we'll make in red. And then we'll take the G function, which we will make in blue, and we are going to multiply these together. So if at any point you feel like you can go a little bit ahead of me, go ahead. We're going to take the F function and write it down. And then we are going to go ahead and multiply it with the G function. And this is just kind of specific notation too, and notation that we see in math. We do this a little bit in Algebra 1, but really we go so much deeper into it. We're going to put these into each other tomorrow. It's called composite functions. So tomorrow is a real new lesson where this is kind of maybe something you've seen in Algebra 1 or previously this year. Okay, we're going to distribute. So I'm going to have you guys help me distribute a little bit. Haley, what will we get when we take the 4x to the second and multiply it with the negative x? Not really, because we're going to have a negative times the 4, so it'll be a, yeah. And then what will the x change to? It won't any longer be to the second, it'll be to the, not to the first, because we're multiplying it, so we add the exponents, so to the third, good, yeah. We just had 2 weeks off, it's okay, we're a little rusty in this. And then we'll just go the 4x to the second to the 5. I'll stick with you for one more. So you're multiplying those numbers. So you're doing the 4x to the second times the 5. Yeah, good, 20. And what would be the x? X to the? Yeah, good, good. I know, I took the break off for math too. You guys were lucky I didn't give you any math homework. Okay, and then Serenity, will you do the next one distributing? It'll be the negative 2x distributed to the negative x. 2x to the second, good. And then I'm going to stick with you for just distributing the next one, the negative 2x to the 5. Negative 10x, very good. Then the last thing we have to distribute is the 3. Mackenzie, can you hit me with that? 3 times the negative x. I love it. And then 3 times the 15. Oh gosh, 3 times the 5 is 15. I gave you the answer, so sorry. Now sometimes when you distribute, you have to go ahead and do what at this point? Add like terms. It doesn't always happen. You're going to have some in the homework where you're just done. But this one, you're going to add like terms. So we're just going to go ahead and have a negative 4x to the third. He doesn't have any friends, but we are going to add these x's to the second together. Valeria, what will I get when I add those together? 22x to the, nice job. Some people make it the fourth, so just be careful there. And then we'll go ahead and we'll add the x's to the first together. What will they add to? How about Richie? Richie, what will those ones add to? Yeah, and what's going to go next to the negative 13x? Yeah, perfect, because the 15 has nothing to add with. We are done. Don't make it any harder than that, but you do need to know the domain. And we'll go ahead and have Steph tell us what's the domain. What's the domain 75% of the time? All real numbers, yeah. So the domain just means what can I plug in? Since there's no exceptions here, no radicals, no fractions, you can plug in any number you want. Do you want to plug in a 2 here, Steph? Go for it. You want to plug in a negative 2? Sure. You want to plug in a fraction? Sure, knock your socks off. You can plug in any number you get. When you plug it in, you'll always get a Y. So that just means the domain is all real numbers. There's a couple other ways we write all real numbers. What's another way? Somebody said it. Yeah, nice and loud. Negative infinity to infinity, right? That's kind of the big kid way of writing it. And then probably the little kid way to write it is write all real. I don't really know another way other than those three, but those are all acceptable. Okay, so far I think it's been gravy. That hasn't been too bad. My youngest went to the mall yesterday and got me this little necklace, so make me think of her. Yeah. We really enjoyed the break with our kids. It was nice. Okay, so now what are we going to do? Ew, it's a fraction. What does fractions mean? Divide. Yep, so we've got to divide now. Now, when you divide things, it matters what's on top. 20 divided by 5 is very different than 5 divided by 20. We know that. So we're going to take the F, and the F has to be on top. So it's going to be 4x to the second minus 2x plus 3 has to be on the top of the fraction, so the order matters. What's going to go on the bottom of the fraction? Negative x plus 5. Good. So that has to go on the bottom. The fraction ones, the division ones, are the ones where you're going to second guess yourself. I have really strong kids. I had a couple really strong ones move over to first period. And the ones that stopped me was always the division when we got to the homework. And that's because a lot of things happen. So when I look at this, what I have to do is when I set up this division problem, I know my domain is not going to just be all real numbers. So that's the first thing I got to be okay with. And the next thing is I have to see if I can factor this. And you guys are going to, you know, vomit a little in your mouth right now because you're going to think about a trinomial with a leading coefficient of 4. And you're going to be like, oh my gosh, do we really need to make a table and see what multiplies and adds? And I'm going to say yes. So what does it multiply to? Good, 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 good. So it has to multiply. That's the AC method. Multiplies to 12. No, they got that. That was really good. And what does it have to add to? Negative 2. Very good. So add to the middle. Now here's the thing that sucks. Sometimes it doesn't factor, and sometimes it does. And I can't say every time it's going to factor and every time it's not. So you just, it's really your strength right here. Are there any numbers that multiply to 12 and add to negative 2? No, there isn't. So this is not factorable. And so what you're going to have to do is just stop. You're done with the problem. This is your answer. You know what I say? I feel like I haven't done any work. Like I didn't do anything, right? There's no way to simplify the top. It's probably a complex number. It's probably an I answer or some kind of really yucky answer. But it's not factorable. So that's your answer. So it's like, how do I know when I have to factor and when I don't? It's either factorable or it's not. And those are your strengths of, do you see factoring when it's there, or do you see that you can not factor in this case? Mm-hmm. If you factor, what will happen will be the U try. So I made one factorable and one not. So when we get to the U try, and this is a 6 right here too. It kind of cut it off a little bit. That's a plus 6. Sorry. So when we get to the next one that you can see right here, don't say out loud, let everybody try, but this will be factorable. So sometimes they factor, sometimes they don't. When they factor, we'll be able to cross things out, and that's going to happen in our U try and in our practice today. There are a lot of things that happen with the division. Now I do have to get to one more thing. You ready? The domain. Steph, what did we say the domain is 75% of the time? All real numbers. But there's an exception. Except X cannot be, with fractions, what's the no-no? I'm not allowed to have what where? I can't have radicals, but I don't have a radical in this one. Sometimes they do put a radical and a fraction together. That really sucks. That'd be pre-calc. You'll get there next year. But in this class, we just have a fraction. So why would the fractions cause a restriction? Or I can have a negative in the denominator, but we are looking at the denominator. So Steph is in the right spot. So it's something about the denominator. What can the denominator not be? Does anybody remember? What can the denominator not be? Huh? No? So we can't have I's in the denominator. We can't have radicals in the denominator, but we can't have zeros. So no zeros here. And you're like, okay, so I can't put a zero there? No. What would make the denominator zero? Well, if you don't know, you take the denominator and you set it equal to zero. And how would I solve? Tell me how to solve. Minus 5. Beautiful. After I minus 5, how do I get x by itself? Divide by negative 1. Nice job. So I'm saying 5. What happens if I put a 5 here? Negative 5 plus 5 gives me 0. So I'm not allowed to have a 5 in the denominator. Why? Because if I took a 5 and put it here, a negative 5 plus a 5 would give me a 0. So the way I find the exception with fractions is I take the denominator and I set it equal to 0. And I'm going to write that over there in the margin. So in order to find the exception, you're going to take the denominator, set it equal to 0, and that will tell you what the exception is. And so the exception is, I can't put a 5 here. I'm not allowed to put a 5 there because negative 5 plus 5 will give me 0. And that's a no-no in the math world. Kind of makes me think of undefined slope. When you have slope, if 0 is in the bottom, it's undefined. It's the vertical line. Kind of makes me think of that. So that's how you find your exception. Exceptions. Okay. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and have you guys start the U-try. I think it's going to be pretty good as we get started for addition, subtraction, multiplication, and then I think I'm going to have to come back up here and help a little bit with the division. A lot, some people got it in first period, but it wasn't everybody. Everybody wasn't there yet, so that's okay. And then after that, we've got our worksheet today, which is green for homework. I'm going to give you guys a song. That Uncle John's band that I went to go see, that they let me down at Crooked Thumb. They're back on Friday, so I'm going to give them another chance. So it'll be a little Grateful Dead this week. so that I can have all my Grateful Dead songs all set. And it's pretty chill music, too. And then I'll come around and check you guys. So go ahead and just get started. How you guys are doing.
I have a new little Stanford too. He's laying out turtle. I bought it. I'm looking for a break. So,
do you guys want to try the new tries? And if you don't know the person you're sitting next to, you can always now, you know, just say hey. Even extremely phone number is good. Yeah, so for this one, the only things that add together are those two. Yeah. And so, yeah, that's good. Yeah, I love the first one. Yeah, it's perfect. Yeah, you guys are doing a great job. Yeah. And our quiz is Tuesday, so we have a little bit of time. There's going to be a lot more before then. It's a lot of information. And then just make sure you guys are practicing your domains and your domains to your domain studio. So, because I like your response. Homework, I just usually put that up at the end. I can't really check the movies at a time. This is good. good. You guys are great. Okay, I'm going to do the first two then. Yeah, this is a good correction. You can bring down your X to the second. Okay, so these can't add together. Okay, yeah, because one's to the first and one's to the second. Okay, let's go ahead and see what we got going on here.
You guys did pretty good.
I love this little stamper. Oh my gosh, he's so fun. I'll show the people online. We have a pet tortoise, so I really like tortoises. They're one of my favorites. Okay, Sandy is our tortoise. Hello, new Sandy. Hi. Hi, Sandy. Okay, so now we'll go ahead and we're just going to add these. I'm going to go a little quickly through the first two just because most people were getting them as I walked around. It's x to the second minus 36. We're going to go ahead and do what the operation says. Be careful on tests. It's going to be plus. And then we're going to add to that the x plus 6, which was a little sloppy just because it cut it off in the when we printed it. When we add like terms, an x to the second cannot be added with an x to the first, so those two just come down. I was telling somebody that I would rearrange it a little differently. Normally we put it in standard form, so the x would normally be before the number. The number's the usually last thing. It's called a constant, and it should be a minus 30. Then your domain would be all real numbers. There are no exceptions. Why? There's no fractions or decimals. You are done with that one. Now we're going to subtract them. What I suggest is when you do subtraction that you use a parentheses. The reason we use a parentheses is we're going to distribute, and a lot of times mistakes are made that they only distribute to the first term and not the whole thing. So when you go ahead and distribute, this is going to change signs.
Teachers and students, please pardon this interruption. Gregory, Gregory, student, if you are on campus, please report to the main office at this time. Teachers, if you will please take a moment prior to the end of second period to just touch base with your classes regarding our OR expectations here on campus. They outline expectations for each area of our campus and expectations here at the Countryside High School. So teachers, if you will please reference your OR expectations prior to the end of second period. Thank you so much, and Gregory,
we'll do that as soon as we're done with the video. Okay. Probably rigor. I don't know. Organization. I don't know. We'll figure it out. It's probably in my email. Sorry. I'm so bad with that. I'm like, delete. No. We will roar, Mr. Henderson, in just a little bit. Okay, so when you multiply, this would be the one that maybe some people made mistakes on, and then we'll go ahead and do the division one. I was going to be careful when I'm being recorded. And then we'll go ahead and distribute. I'll stop the music just while we do these last two because these are the two harder ones. If you don't need me anymore, just move on to your homework. When you take an x to the second times an x, you get an x to the third. When you take an x to the second times a 6, you get a 6x to the second. When you take a negative 36 times an x, you get a negative 36x. And when you do a negative 36 times a 6, you get a negative 216. This is one of the exceptions where there is no like terms or are no like terms to add together. Sorry, bad English. And then the domain is all real numbers, so right now this would not be where I would think there would be a lot of issues in the lesson. Where the issues are going to come in are probably going to be with the division. As soon as we see fractions, division, we see factoring, it's easy to not know what to do. The first thing that's important is that the f function, which is the x to the second minus 36, has to go on top. And on the bottom has to go the g function. The g function is the x plus 6. If you get to there, you've done pretty well, but your factoring skills need to come to the front of your brain. Does anybody remember the name of this factoring or how to do it? It has a specific name. It's a shortcut. You did not have to do a table what multiplies and adds. Instead, binomial. Very good. So it's a binomial. That's how I recognize it. What does it have in it? What's this called? Square, so the perfect square ones are called. It's got subtraction. Yeah, good, difference of squares. It's really nice if you can kind of get that down. So what we'll do is we'll see some difference of squares, we'll see some tables, what multiplies and adds, the AC method. So we'll see all different, we'll see GCFs in the homework, and that's why you really gotta do the homework so that you see all of those different types of factoring coming forward before Tuesday. When we go ahead and factor this, and the only ones I have to factor are the division ones. So I never factor up above. Like, I don't have to see if this is factorable. I don't have to see if any of these are factorable. You're done, okay? So only the ones that have division. So what is the green factor to? X plus what? And X what? Good, yes. And then the bottom is the X plus 6. And so this is where Imelda was asking me what happens when we factor. What happens? You can cross out. It's a way to simplify, but you cannot do that until you factor. So you have to factor these ones in order to cross out. So on the notes that we did together, they didn't cross out, and this one it crossed out. So your answer is just X minus 6. That's a little simplified. And then we'll talk about domain. So the domain is all real numbers, except what would be the restriction? What can the X not be for this? Positive 6 would make the denominator 12. Negative 6, good. So X cannot be negative 6. And that's probably the part where some of you are like, I have no idea where crazy lady's getting that. She's taking the denominator and she's setting it equal to 0. And when you minus 6 from both sides, that tells me, oh no, lady, you cannot put a negative 6 in there. Negative 6 plus 6 gives me 0. So that's how you get your exceptions. A lot of you will just do it by looking at it. You'll just be able to look and say, oh, a negative 6 would make that 0. But I show the work for anyone that doesn't get it. So I'm going to put up the key now. I'm going to go ahead and stop the video. Guys, have a great day. If you missed class.